Very good morning to all the students of class plus 1B. First of all, I would like to wish you all a very happy World Environment Day. And we are doing a chapter, Ailing Planet, the Green Movement's Role, which is very much connected with this today's, you can say, event. So this is a mere happy coincidence that we are doing this chapter on this very day. So we are blessed enough to understand and let's be responsible. Before, you know, starting, I have written, you can see, just a small quote. Like yesterday, I have written, let's go green before the green goes. These are the two quotes which I personally follow. Don't be mean. Let's go green. In very simple words. Even a child of class nursery or LKG can learn this quote. Don't be mean. Let's go green. But this small quote is carrying heavy meaning in itself, which is also one of the themes of this chapter, Ailing Planet. We people are having mean attitude. Fine, this quote can be used as one of the themes of this chapter, Ailing Planet. Fine, so let's start with this. I have written a few points. Kindly note down side by side. And these points will help you definitely to understand the chapter. So we have read so far till Lusaka, Zambia. You remember that incident, or you can say that example, in the zoo of Lusaka, Zambia, there is a mirror and this is a cage is there. In that cage, a mirror is there. If we see our picture in that mirror, there is no animal inside the cage. Only mirror is there, and this is written above that the world's most dangerous animal. So actually it is a satire on all the human race that man is the most dangerous animal, because man is responsible for depletion of all the species, plants, human beings, earth, everything is connected in a chain. And if any imbalance occurs, it will affect all of us. We cannot think that if there is a less number of species and it will not affect us. Definitely, we will be affected in one or the other way. Clear? So I have written this chapter is, firstly, remember those who were absent yesterday. This chapter is written in the form of an article. Fine? This is not a story. This is written in the form of an article. Facts are given in this article. Quotes are given in this article written by eminent environmentalists. Fine? And they have tried to create awareness among us after reading this article. Find that we would be realizing that what is our responsibility as a human being. Okay, beta? So, firstly, I have written it's an article only. You need to note down the points. Green movement, I have discussed in detail yesterday what is green movement. Fine. And it started in 1972 in New Zealand, but soon it became so famous that many people, politicians, private organizations, government, and many countries even started joining in. And it became a movement, only a universal or global movement. The people started initiating in their own countries even. It was about creating awareness among masses about saving this Mother Earth. Then in this article, Nani Palkhiwala, I have written the name because this is written by, you know, when you write article writing in writing skill, you just write the heading and then you write the writer's name beneath. Fine. This is the way we write writer's name also. So growing awareness. Writer here is saying that we cannot say that only negativity is there or some negative points that people are not aware. Awareness is being generated. This green movement role also has a very important role in creating awareness, and otherwise also people are getting aware. Then we have a Brunswick Commission report, and Mr. L.K. Jha, one of the prominent Indians, he was the member of this committee. You know, government when wants to start any initiative, regardless of anything, it can be related to some law, it can be related to some current issue. They form committees on the basis of their qualification, on the basis of their, you can say, experience. So L.K. Jha was member of that committee that we would be reading in the chapter fine, about that, what is written in that report, what statement was given by this report, and what awareness was created by this group, this commission. Okay, so these points actually are the questions only, beta. Fine, these are the questions only. You can get a question about branded commission report. You can get a question about what is green movement. Fine, that's why I have created points out of it. Then Lester R. Brown in the Global Economic Prospect. In this, you can say book, he has mentioned, he has written one thoughtful book, I must say, Lester Brown. He has written, these all are environmentalists who are quite aware about the environment and concerned also. The Global Economic Prospect, he has mentioned these four areas, fisheries, forests, grasslands, and cropland, that we would be reading that how they are the, you can say, foundation of the economic system. These four sectors actually are the foundation of the economic system. Even if one will be affected, the rest of the chain definitely will be affected. Clear? We will be reading in detail in the chapter. I'm just giving you the gist then. Forests precede mankind, deserts follow. Very beautiful statement it is, and having the deeper meaning. It means before the existence of humankind, there were forests. Precede means before. Forests precede mankind, deserts follow. Means after the existence of human beings, when human beings came into existence, when population increased, then what happened? Forests got converted into deserts. It means, who is responsible for this deterioration? We people, human beings. We are cutting the trees like anything, cutting the forest at rapid speed just to make buildings and factories and shopping malls. Fine. So this statement says that forests are being cut every second, every minute, just for the, you can say, metropolitan cities are there, commercialization, many reasons are there. Even villages are converting themselves into small towns. Many buildings are being built up. Definitely one should grow, but not at the cost of this mother nature. That's why we people are lacking oxygen these days. Have you ever imagined in your lives that we would be buying oxygen? We would be buying our breaths? Actually, we are the buying the breaths only. How disheartening it is to know when we see everyday people are dying due to the lack of oxygen. Everything is related. Whatever we eat, whatever surroundings we are living in, what we are inhaling inside. Fine. So that's why these viruses are having upper hand these days, because we people never bothered about our surroundings. Fine. Then Article 48A of the Constitution is mentioned here. Fine. In that, they would be telling, in Article 48, they would be beta mentioning that Constitution of India provides that state shall put efforts to protect the environment. It is not the duty of individuals only. State shall, and the central government, they should also take care of the environment. They should put in effort. They should grow more trees. They should start some committee or NGOs. So they should work for the benefit of states and put efforts. Then population is the major cause of deterioration of nature. Clear? Then I would be like, if you can see beta, I have just changed the position. You can note down the rest of the points now. It's mentioned that transcending concern. It means concern is changing day by day. People are growing, you can say, mentally. People are becoming aware mentally. They know that nature is quite important. You know that people have started kitchen gardens at home these days. Some people are growing gardens at their rooftop, even if they do not have places. You know, these days people are having the wall gardens. Fine, you can, it's your up to you only, whether you're having small houses, whether you're having not, you can say, places or not. You just, everybody's trying to manage the pots or greenery around them. Fine, so people are getting aware and they are not depleting the nature also. Many people, the well-educated and those who understand the importance, fine. So there is a change among the masses. People are getting aware. Then we have role of industries. You know, a lot of waste every year or every, you can say, minute industries are producing waste, and where do they throw the waste? In the oceans, in the seas, in the rivers, sometimes there is huge, you can say, accumulated waste. And if they will be polluting the waters, we would be again getting affected lately. So they would be telling us, at the same time, I told you, Nani Palkhiwala has shown two sides of the coin. One is good, another is bad. Fine, people are getting concerned about it. This is good, but still there is a lot to be done. Some people are not aware, that is bad. Yeah. Then we have not inherited. At last, I have written a quote given by Lester Brown only, which is the one of the questions also. We have not inherited this earth from our forefathers, you can say, but we have borrowed it from our children. Fine. It means we have borrowed it. If we have borrowed something from someone, we have to give it back to them. Clear? If suppose you have taken money from someone, you have borrowed anything, will you keep it with yourself only? Won't you return it? If you have taken money from or borrowed money from someone, definitely you're going to return it. Similarly, if you have borrowed this earth from your children, you have to give it back to them. And if you use the thing of a person, you will not distort it. You will return the thing in proper, intact manner only. So similarly, here comes the concept of sustainable development, which we discussed already yesterday. That use the resources to that extent that they are left for your future generations or posterity. Is it clear to everyone? So let's not... Clear, beta? All the points I have discussed, whatever is written on the board is discussed with all of you now. If you have doubt in any of the points, you can ask me, send me thumbs up. I am checking in between those who are attending or not. If you want, you're not switching on the video, so send me thumbs up. Those who are sitting, Harnoor Kaur, send me the thumbs up, beta. I'm just seeing whether you are attending or not. Yes. Raghav Dhawan. Okay, fine. So this is the way to check whether you are paying attention or not. Now, before continuing the reading, you just tell me, who will tell me the meaning of posterity? I guess 4 to 5 times I have used since yesterday. Meaning of posterity. Deliberately, I was using this word and told you the meaning also. Raise your hand. We have not... you can say we have borrowed this. Sahaj Preet, beta, unmute yourself first and speak.
Ma'am, it means the coming generation, the future generation.
Very good. Fine. So that shows that you are paying attention to vocabulary also. This word is not mentioned here in this chapter. Maybe they have, might have mentioned somewhere, but you have not read it so far. So the way I'm checking that you are listening to the teacher. So let's continue now. We were on page number 44. So we have read about Visakha Zambia. That is over. Now we would be continuing, beta, from scientists have cataloged about 1.4 million living species onwards. Fine, page 44. So in this, beta, they have given the data now. That how many species are living on this earth and how at rapid speed they are deteriorating just because of our fault. Fine, we people are becoming mean. The way I have written, don't be mean, go green. We are having mean attitude. We are the reason behind depletion of, you know, there were many sparrows earlier days when I was at your age. We could see that thousands of sparrows lurking over the, you can say, roofs, and we would throw breadcrumbs or roti to them and they would come in numbers. But have you seen small sparrows, a particular species of sparrows? These days it's very less in number. Only 1 and 2 or 3 we can find around our roofs. Why they are dying at faster pace? Because of this networking, this 5G, 4G, 3G, 2G we have started. We are improving the technology, but we have, you know, there is depletion in many species. They say that because there are, you can say, what do we call that in technology, that there are races in there, and because of those rays, the many sparrows, you can say they are dying at faster pace because of technologies. Everywhere, see, we are using Wi-Fi now. Without this, we are not going to work. But anyhow, we are paying for it also. Clear? So in this, scientists have cataloged about 1.4 million living species with which mankind shares the earth. Estimates vary widely as regards the still uncataloged living species. So they are saying there are more than 1.4 million living species and which are cataloged. If you see Discovery Channel, they would be telling us there are n number of species, but at the same time there are the species which are not even cataloged. Cataloged is list is not made because they are not able to find it even. The found species are more than 1.4 million. Underline the data. Biologists reckon that about 3 to 100 million other living species still languish unnamed. Underline the word beta, languish. This is a difficult word, you need to note down. Forced to stay somewhere else. Languish here means forced to stay somewhere else. Fine. So biologists reckon that about 3 to 100 million other living species still languish unnamed in ignominious darkness. Ignominious here means unknown, or you can say disgraceful also we say, but here in this context, this is unknown. Means many species which are not even known to us. Clear? One of the early international commissions which dealt inter alia. Inter alia means underline among others. Inter alia here means among others. With the question of ecology and environment was the Branded Commission, which had a distinguished Indian as one of its members, Mr. L.K. Jha. See the point I have already mentioned about Branded Commission, Mr. L.K. Jha, who was one of the prominent Indians in that committee. What report was given by them? We would be discussing that. Kindly pay attention, quite important. The first branded report raised the question, underline this, are we to leave our successors a scorched planet of advancing deserts, impoverished landscapes, and ailing environment? So this was the question raised by this branded commission, in which L.K. Jha was one of the members, that are we to leave our successors as the coming generation, a scorched planet of advancing deserts. We will be leaving deserts for them. We are cutting trees at such a faster pace. What we are leaving for our coming generation? Mr. Lester R. Brown, in his thoughtful book, The Global Economic Prospect, points out that the Earth's principal biological systems are four. I have already mentioned. Diya, will you repeat it? Unmute yourself and speak.
Ma'am, fishes, forests, grassland, croplands.
Very good. Fine. So I have already discussed. There are four major basic sectors of economy, or you can say global economic system: fisheries, forests, grassland, cropland. If you forget anyone, two starts from word F, fisheries and forests. Sometimes children forget while writing. Fine. And the rest of them, they are having the word land in them, cropland, grassland. In this way, you will remember it. Fine. So they form the foundation of global economic system. In addition to supplying our food, these four systems provide virtually all the raw materials for industry, except minerals and petroleum-derived synthetics. What is the importance of these four, you can say, sectors of economy? They, no doubt, they provide food for us, which is the basic reason of our survival. Fine, people are having the crops and that's why we are surviving. We eat wheat, maize, barley, rice, fine. And after that, we have fish also, some people who are non-vegetarian. So whatever food requirements are there, these are fulfilled by these four sectors. But not only this, they provide raw materials for industry also. There are many things which are provided by these lands so that many industries could work. Fine. In large areas of the world, human claims on these systems are reaching an unsustainable level, a point where their productivity is being impaired. But now there is a claim that there is a hindrance. There is a stoppage in between. It is getting impaired. Productivity is getting affected. Why? Because the system is getting affected. All the sectors are getting affected. So the fact is that industries are also not getting material. Clear? We are only having 5 minutes, beta. So we would be completing, I guess, 2 paragraphs or 3 paragraphs. You know, try to understand, beta. Each and every line carries a question, and each and every line is quite important for you. Now, very beautifully written, in a protein conscious and a protein hungry world. You might have seen that people go to gyms these days. How conscious they have become about their bodies. That how much protein I should intake, how much carbs I should intake. That is the protein conscious world. Fine. Then there is protein hungry world. And there is another sector, poor sector of the society, which are not having basic amenities even. Fine. They are protein hungry people. So the actually writer Nani Palkhiwala has beautifully mentioned the two sectors, the two groups. One is rich, the other one is poor. Fine. So he's saying that in a protein conscious and protein hungry world, overfishing is common every day. In poor countries, local forests are being decimated in order to procure firewood for cooking. Clear? So cook for our basic reasons, what we are doing, we people are cutting forest at very fast pace. It is being decreased, decimated, even it is getting disappeared. Fine, because they need firewood for cooking. Poor people cannot afford gas. They cannot afford cylinders. They cut the wood only from the forest to have their meals, to cook their meals. In some places, firewood has become so expensive that what goes under the pot now costs more than what goes inside it. Again, beautifully mentioned. What goes under the pot? You know that people use fire woods to cook their meals. Even now, wood has become quite costly. So even if it is costlier than the meal even. From, you can say, when we compare the price of the wood with compare price of the vegetables, it is more. So what goes under the pot is even more costlier. Since the tropical forest is, in the words of Dr. Mears, the powerhouse of evolution, several species of life face extinction as a result of its destruction. Several species of life, many species have already got extinction. They are not, as I discussed the sparrows scene with you, that we are not able to see such small sparrows these days. And there are n number of species which have, either they have migrated, the migratory birds are there, they have migrated, or some have even died. They are not even into extinction just because of forests is the home to them. And if forests will be cut at faster pace, where would they go? Are we building any alternative for them? There is no alternative for them. So they have to die. If the home is not there, they need to survive on plants, leaves, flowers only. So they are just extinction, on the verge of extinction, or they have already extincted. Then it has been very well said that forests precede mankind. This is the last point which I have written, you can see today. And after this, I would be ending this meet. It has been very well said that forests precede mankind, deserts follow. The world's ancient patrimony of tropical forests is now eroding. It's just going, vanishing at the rate of 40 to 50 million acres a year. You can underline, this is the data, 40 to 50 million acres a year. And the growing use of dung for burning deprives the soil of an important natural fertilizer. You know that cow dung and the dung of the animals, which is a very important fertilizer for us. Fine, everything is getting affected. I already told you it's a chain reaction. The World Bank estimates that a 5-fold increase in the rate of forest planting is needed to cope up with the expected fuel wood demand in the year 2000. But it is 2021 going on. So it might be more than that. So they are saying that 5-fold rate of forest plantation is required. But what we are doing, we are again cutting the forests. So who is responsible? man is responsible. Rest beta, we would be continuing from this James Speth page 45 onwards. We could not complete this chapter because you got a lot of, you can say, I took your class in the beginning because of your attendance and the way you conducted, yes, or you can say performed in the test. So just prepare well. Tomorrow is Sunday. Please take lessons for English and physical education as seriously as you're taking other three subjects. Okay. Otherwise, at the end, you have to suffer a lot. Okay, beta. And you should be present in all the periods. If any emergency is there,